Welcome to Team Doctor's Blog. This is Dr. James Stockson. Here we are in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. And I'm lecturing tomorrow about the human spring mechanism in barefoot running. Now, the human spring mechanism is a mechanism that protects us from the landings by the spring mechanism is between our body and the ground. When two parts collide, if they don't have something in between them to absorb the impact, they're going to get injured or damaged. So what our bodies have is a spring mechanism that lies between our joints and the ground to absorb that impact. So one of the floors of the human spring today we're going to deal with is the second floor, or ankle joint number one. That's the subtalar joint for medical reasons, medical terminology, you don't have to know that. But here's the points right here. You work along the edge of the ankle bone right here and the Achilles tendon. You're going to find like a little gully or a little notch there. And you're going to apply the pressure with your thumb right down to the bone. And I can feel it. Oh, there, right against that ankle bone. And I'm applying the pressure. And I'm holding it, and I can feel the pain starting to go away. Now, don't be alarmed by the pain. It'll go away. Just hold it down. Push all the way down to the bone till we get all out of there. Now, I'm going to, as the pain is gone, when it's gone, not just down, I'm going to go to the next point. I'm going to go along the edge of that ankle bone to release the subtalar joint. And go all the way along the edge of this subtalar joint like this, and then right in here where you get those ankle sprains, right on those ankle sprains area, sprain areas, that triangular ligament, and then hold that point until the pain goes away, and then hook around to the opposite, or this area right here, and hold it till it goes away. After you're done, you take your ankle and you can move it around like this, and you're gonna hear maybe some clicking where the ankle is actually releasing, and that means that the spring mechanism is releasing. So now more force can be absorbed into the spring mechanism because it's released. If it's locked, then the force bangs into the ground rather than the foot springing off of the ground. That's what you want. So by releasing the human spring, your foot will spring off the ground and your mass will spring off the ground rather than banging into the ground in what I call the bang and the twist, the bang and the twist, the bang and the twist. You know, you take 3.6 million steps per year. In 10 years, that's 36 million steps. In 30 years, it's over 100 million steps. In your lifetime, it's 275 million steps. So if your spring mechanism is not released and you bang and twist enough, there's not going to be much left of your joints. So preserve your human spring, release ankle joint number one, and do it regularly. So that's a great next tip for you about how to release the human spring. Stay tuned for the next one from Team Doctor's Blog.